Hi everyone, it's Saf. Welcome to B17 Flying Fortress, the Mighty Eighth. I've been getting a lot of messages over the last weeks, months actually, about how to actually play this game, and people asking for various tutorials. Now, I'm not going to do a tutorial on everything, because I'll be here forever. But I thought one of the most common things people always ask is about the bombing, which after all is the main point of the game. So, one of the things I would say is if you go to New Game, and you go to training missions, right at the bottom of here, I do recommend you do all of these: take off and landing, approach and landing, feather, restarting of engine, bombing good conditions, bombing poor conditions. So if we do the bombing good conditions, just an example, and I'll talk you through how to do a bombing. It's not going to be everything, it's just going to be the basics, so you can get up there and have a bash for yourself. In this mission, you must fly a mission to the target and bomb it. Okay, mission used too many times, I think. The weather is favourable and the altitude is low and there is no flak or fighter opposition to jog your elbow. The bomber starts in the bomb run with no obstructions to the target, and this is a fine introduction to the workings of the Norden bomb site. Okay, fine. Boom.
Join formation. Your new heading is 1-8.
Okay, so if we just quickly have a look on the navigation. Okay, we're coming up to, this is the start of the bomb run here. So we're over North Norfolk, there's King's Lynn, there's that bomb training that we always fly over, and our base is over there somewhere. So we're going to come up to the turn shortly. We'll stay in the bomber's position. Now, for those of you who are new to the game, if you right-click on the bombardier, he has two options. He doesn't at the moment, actually. Let's stick him on that gun. And then I can talk you through his two options. Right, now he's off there. You go there, we've got two options. We've got the chin turret, which you put them on for defence of the B-17. But we've also got the bombardier position. So we'll click on bombardier, so he goes to the Norden bomb site. They're both situated from that same seat. But once he's there, we can press W to have a look out the window. We still haven't made the turn yet. A will take us into the bomb site view itself. And I will take us to look at the Norden bomb site itself. So this is where we look through. There's the gauges there, and this is the drift meter. So if we're drifting, we can grab that little thing and pull it either way to adjust our drift.
Pilot navigator.
Okay. Right, so from the bombardier's position, we can also press spacebar, and this will take us to the bombardier's instrument panel. So we've got the switch the panel on. This is the bomb release, and this is the bomb bay doors, and then you can adjust how the bombs are going to drop, basically, the different rack selections, etc. We can arm the bombs, and we put the autopilot on. So they are the options we have. Okay, so there we go. We've just selected on, gone onto the bomb run, and because we're not in manual control, he's switched the bomb indicator on. He's opened the doors, armed the bombs, and put the autopilot on. So that's what we got here. So if we go back to A, which will take us to the bomb site, we will have a look for the target. We are still quite a distance from it. Boom. But I'm going to take manual control now, because I don't want him to do anything else. We've still got some way to go. But what you can do from the bomb site, when you're in manual control, is hit Shift and letter K together, and that will give you free movement of the crosshairs. As you can see that grass circle in there, so let's aim for the middle of that grass circle. And what we can do then is press Shift K again, and that will lock the crosshairs into that position. Now if I try and move the controller to the left, nothing happens. To the right, nothing happens. But I still have vertical control. So let me just reset that, because I did that a bit extremely. So we shift control back into the center, and we'll keep an eye on it. Now, if we were drifting left or right, you would hit the I key, and you would adjust the drift indicator accordingly. So if we're drifting to the left, you'd move it, and then we'd correct our course. Hit A to come back to the bomb screen. We're not actually in the middle, I don't think, there. But we're quite a ways away from the moment, so it's not too much of a problem. So I've just gone to Shift K again, so I got track mode. Let's stick it right in the old pickle barrel in the middle. And basically what we want to do is as the target comes to us, we want the crosshairs to drift down with it, so it almost looks like you're zooming into a picture. That is how you lock on. What you will notice, so obviously we've locked on to the crosshairs here, and this is set this little measurement here. This one is basically the... I always think of it as the aircraft coming towards the target location. That's the target location we've locked, and this is the aircraft. So when these two meet, you'll get the cue indicator, and the bombs will automatically be released. So you should start to see this one creeping up as we get closer, but we are still a fair distance away. As I say, this is not... There's loads of other things you can be doing at the same time, but you know, this is the basics. I'm not happy with that, actually. I'm going to stick us about there. Is that in the middle? It's difficult to say. I'd say that's probably the middle right there. Okay, now normally you've been absolutely bombarded by flak and enemy fighters at this time, so it's a really nice introduction to actually do it without any other distractions other than just the target in front of you. And of course, we're not being impacted by crosswinds or anything here. This is just a tutorial, so it's perfect weather conditions, still sky, and everything is absolutely perfect. We're at 8,000 feet, so we're pretty low. There's no cloud cover. This is slowly making its way up. I may just speed up time a little bit. So I'm using the home and the end keys to speed time up to 2, 4, and 8 times speed. And you can see we're actually drifting slightly. So let me readjust that. We'll go back into the center. And let's just see again, and you can watch this slowly creep its way up. So we are drifting slightly. So if we adjust that, we're probably a bit much. This is a touch sensitive, so I'm going to go put 0.7. Wait for it to settle down. So that was I to get back to this screen, and then you just grab this with the left mouse button and move it yourself. It's kind of a little bit of a guesswork. Well, you always do it with a bit of that feeling and guesswork, but that seems to be pretty locked on center. This is slowly creeping up now. If we just speed up time a quick, can you see that? It looks like we're zooming in on the target. It's not actually perfect because it's actually drifting slightly. So if I lock that in there, and you can hold a little bit of pressure on the controller if you're using a joystick to try and track the target, then you can let shift K when you're happy with it, and you should get a sense of us zooming in and looking in on the target. As I say, you can use the up and down to adjust the or decrease or increase the crosshairs movement. But you just want to get it locked on so it, whatever you're going, it stays on the same part of the map which you're aiming for. As I say, I'm actually a little bit short of it, so I just pulled it back a bit to increase the range, as it were. And now we're locked onto the corner of that building. Actually, should we bring it up? Let's bring it up so we're actually on that corner of the building about there. You shouldn't do all this adjustment. I'm just doing this for showing you what you can do. So we're going to try and stick to the top corner of that building. We are drifting a little bit, so I again. God damn, it's so sensitive. There we go. A to go back to the site, and as you can see, we're going to stay on the side of that building. We're dropping down a little bit. It looks like we're now zooming in. The crosshairs are reasonably stable, and you can see what I call the aircraft indicator coming to meet the target indicator. And when these lines a line, as it were, you'll get the bomb cue and the bomb release. We are drifting still. We are drifting left. But there we go. Bombs away. F6 now. Press the F6 key and that'll take you to the bombs being dropped. F6 again and you'll see your target. Now we were aiming... Here's our shadow. So we're aiming for this part of the building. So I reckon bombs are going to probably drop about here because we were drifting slightly. Oh, well, there you go. Well, I knew they were going to come there. But I thought they would be a little bit later than that. And that is our bomb run. It's not the best, actually. We could have slit the racks so they all dropped at once, but it's probably just as well we didn't because it all dropped here. Oh, and that's the end of the mission. That's quick. It takes a bit of practice. Even I got that wrong. I know we still hit the target, but that was not a perfect bomb run by any means. Congratulations, you have displayed the required standard for competence and familiarity with the procedures for using the Norden bomb site. You have completed the training mission successfully, and then we've got our bomb damage. So, yeah, even I make mistakes, and I've been playing this game for years and years and years and years and years. You very rarely make a perfect bomb run, but that's the basics. I'll maybe annotate the screen with the keystrokes, and that's all I wanted to do, to show you what keystrokes you do to go through the bombing procedure. There's loads more you can do to adjust how you want to bomb, drop all the bombs at once, and select which racks at time you want to drop. But don't worry about that for now. All you want to do is drop the bombs in the vicinity of the target area, and that's probably all I wanted to show you today. So I hope this has been helpful. If it hasn't, then I'm sorry I've wasted your time, but I hope it has helped some of the people new to the game. So thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.